one of our next generation power buoys has been deployed for a customer in US waters. It's sitting now in Monterey Bay, a couple of miles off the California coastline, streaming live data back to MPS over AT&T's 5G network.
Hey, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Philipp Stratmann. He is the CEO of Ocean Power Technologies. And Philipp, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Doing well. Good to be on, Steve.
So, Philipp, news out today about the company hitting yet another milestone. And this is a key one, especially when you talk about what's happening in the United States.
Yeah, this is we're super excited about this one. And this is the first time one of our next generation power buoys has been deployed for a customer in US waters. It's sitting now in Monterey Bay, a couple of miles off the California coastline, streaming live data back to MPS over AT&T's 5G network. I mean, it's that's a pretty exciting move.
Yeah, talk to me a bit about the 5G tower. This is obviously another key milestone of this.
Yeah, so it's obviously a power boom, and we've said in the past that we're pretty sensor agnostic. Well, if one of the sensors could be an AT&T 5G mast, now you've got the ability to tap into the public 5G network that exists out in the ocean. Obviously, this is not currently meant as a commercial deployment of 5G tech out in the ocean, but it enables the data that is being collected from the sensors on the buoy to be streamed through the 5G network back to its destination. And just think what that opens up in terms of opportunities for communication for obviously first responders and defense and security, primarily initially, and then rolling it out to the broader public at a later stage. I think it's an exciting step forward, and we're really glad that we got to work with AT&T on this one.
Yeah, I would imagine also you've talked in the past about the importance of being able to showcase the technology and what you do to new and potential customers. And this really allows you to that opportunity to show in a way that's not been seen in the US before.
Absolutely. What you now have is essentially an installed test bed for anybody who's got ideas that for underwater sensors or surface sensors or various drone integrations they want to work on that require a persistent and resident power source and a communications link out in the ocean. So be that Navy, be that Homeland Security, it could be parts of Customs and Border Patrol, it could be the scientific community. If you look at what we've got there, you've got, Stanford is nearby, you've got Barry nearby. There's a whole bunch of scientific efforts and entities that are in the region that, can now go and, hey, I've got this idea. Can I attach this to your buoy? And, we'll work with Naval Postgraduate School on continuing to deploy whatever sensors somebody might think about.
Well, you look at the US alone, 13,000 nautical miles. And as you mentioned, there's a lot of entities and whether you're not in California and then moving along the coastline, there's lots of these little organizations, I think, that would benefit from that type of technology.
Absolutely. If you think about, the length of the exclusive economic zone around the United States is about 13,000 nautical miles or thereabouts. Just the amount of work that goes on in there and the value creation for our economy that occurs within the EEZ, now you're starting to enable an entirely different set of operations that can occur there. Right now, the only people that can do a benefit from the blue economy inside the United States EEZ are people that have big boats. Well, if you start adding in buoys with communications links and underwater and surface sensors, well, you're opening up to robots. You're opening up to all sorts of underwater and surface assets. And you're really starting to make it a much safer for all sorts of other efforts, be they recreational or commercial. So I think that's a pretty exciting step forward here for the United States and in North America. And then obviously something that we can then start replicating in other parts of the world. So yeah, this is one of those where we're super excited about having something in there with a commercial customer and just being able to showcase the breadth of use cases that our systems enable.
Well, congratulations. Another key milestone for the company as you move things forward. Philip, thanks very much. Good to see you again.
Great. Thanks, Steve. Good to be on as always.
All right, Phil Stratmann, the CEO of Ocean Power Technologies.